Nice there from Patrick. Beautiful angle. Nice early timing. Tied Burnie up into the middle and then played wide. Good tactics from the Indian.
One.
What the heck is happening there from Batcher's backhand? It's a good question. She uses long pips, also known as reverse pimples, because it does exactly that. Reverses whatever spin you give to it.
2-1.
She's going to have to be wary of that, Burnie, because if she chooses to loop into the backhand side, she's going to have to be on the receiving end of a loaded backspin ball.
1-3.
One trump that I think Burnie has over Batra is the serve game. She has a more versatile portfolio of serves, the Romanian.
1-4.
And body language so far is indicating Burnie is still riding on cloud nine. Fresh off the back of a great win against Adriana Diaz as well in the last round.
4-2.
I don't honestly think she could be any more confident unless she beat Sasha. I'm looking at the draw. Speaking of Sasha, winner of this will play Chan Meng.
4-3.
Top Chinese player, current Olympic champion, in fact. Nice
switch,
straight away. Good initiative from Burnie. Misses a ball that she would like to make there, Batra. Looked really attackable by the fact that it was quite high, but it was good placement right into that deep corner from Soch.
6-4.
Batra's a tall player, which means she's got a bigger crossover section to hit into. She'll try and protect the middle with those long pips.
7-4.
Burnie's playing it brilliantly right now. Not afraid to push back and get a ball there that she's a bit more accustomed to. Good anticipation as well.
4-8.
She has doubled the points of her opponent here in game one. Nice touch there. Half long. Batra couldn't brush up very comfortably. Two away from racing into a 1-0 lead. Burnie Soch.
10,
make that
four.
One. Six game points. This has been a fantastic opener. And there we
11,
have it.
Four. First
well,
game.
Well, well.
Research. One.
Just to give you a bit of context into this match, it's Burnie Soch levels
one.
There. The last three times they've played each other, Batra has won. The last encounter was 3-0 to Batra. March last season at the Contender Oman. Time before that, Batra won 3-2. And the time before that, 3-1. So Burnie will feel like she has a point to prove here. Right down the line. She made it look effortless there. That again is the disadvantage of the long pips if you play it correctly. You can't really put too much pressure on your opponent.
three, two.
But the forehand of Batra is top class. Top class. Batra's style is inspired by a lady called Neha Argaval, 2008 Olympian from India, who I had the pleasure of commentating with in Goa. This is where this kind of long pip trend on the backhand side has come from.
Five, two.
Better here from Manika.
Five, two. Three, five.
Fundamentals here, just keeping the ball tight. Burnley doesn't want to so willingly send the ball long unless it's with a bit more oomph.
Seven, three.
You can hear their Balgo in the background. Really vocal.
Let. Seven, three.
Nice pressure into the backhand eight, side from three. Batra. Those forehands are flowing very fluidly indeed. Burnley just a little bit too close to the table there, a little bit too upright with the block.
4-8.
Six of the last eight to Batra. Not taking the towel break there, Burnley. Not sweaty enough. Well, she's got her right where she wants her here, Batra. She can taste this game on the tip of her tongue. Can she seal the deal?
9-5.
This could be another grueling five-gamer for Burnley Soch. Brilliant play from Batra. She's just using Burnley's pace against her here. Like a shield. Deflecting it back. Some of the best table tennis we've seen this match so far. Look at that backhand away from the table from Burnley. Wow, what a loop.
10-8.
She got long for that one. Got the net. That is a very, very good shot. I think he's telling her there just to try and get her out wide, switch her around. I think Balgo is trying to say. The tactic was good, but Burnley Soch is being an absolute nuisance for Batra right now. She's just breathing down her neck, and the timeout called a good timeout. Twiddles on the service and fires the forehand. Manika Batra of India with the serves. Wow, that was a really fluid counter topspin. Nicely done. Silky smooth. Just pushes through with the long pips and Burnley's like, thank you very much, Manika. I will take that any day of the week. It's a lot of bling on that left wrist. Definitely one of the more marketable players, Bernie Sotz, with that pink rubber as well. Oh, well, that rally there really epitomising the crafty, cunning nature of table tennis. Yep.
4-2.
She's not going to miss those forehands, the kind of form that she's in here. En route to this last 16, Sotz beat Chan Soo-yu 3-0. And then that great win against Diaz, 3-2. Batra beat Margarita Pazotska from Ukraine, a really consistent player. But then,
4-3.
A win that really, really took the world by surprise. She defeated Zheng Yiqing, Team Chinese Taipei's number one, in 3 straight games.
Four all.
Slow spin there from Bernie Sotz. Almost silent the contact, which indicates a hell of a lot of spin. I think the touch of Bernie is a much improved shot of hers. She's always been quite good in the rally. But a tight game. Really, really important recipe for success.
Seven,
she comes over that. It's a big swing of Bernie. Really important, despite how much your body moves, to keep the head still in table tennis, to get the control. Whoa!
Five.
That would have been a nice finish. She just stands there with the backhand, just didn't really do any movement at all, Batra.
Five, eight.
Trying to twiddle and punch there, Manica. Just give Bernie a different kind of flatter ball. Didn't have time to twiddle for the second one. Twiddling takes time, and there's not a lot of time in TT. Oh, it came down.
9-5.
And I think Bernie there mishit the backhand winner. If she didn't, I apologise, but it sounded like that.
9-6. Six, 10.
A seesawing round of 16 match here, and Bernie looking to get her nose back in front, 2-1. 4 game points to do it.
Seven, 10.
All this hard work
11, 7,
is paying 13, off here for Bernie Sotch. She's won the European Top 16 before and the T2. But she is lacking in WTT events.
Left one.
Batra will feel the same. Speaking of Chung Mong, the winner of this plays the Olympic champ. If you were Chung Mong, who would you rather play? Who do you think you'd have a better chance of beating?
One, three.
Interested in this matchup, we haven't seen Bernie Sotch do her tomahawk serve so much. Mostly the pendulum.
Yes, 1-4.
Oh, you can hear Batra's coach there is chuffed to bits. Balgo, Aman Balgo.
Let 1-4.
Great shot.
5-1.
Both those finishing forehands from Batra were nice. Bigger stroke there just to finish things off. No reaction from her. She knows she's in the trenches. And she's going to have to dig very deep indeed to beat Bernie Sotch.
6-1.
Looks like we're going to a fifth. Don't want to speak too soon, but 6-1 up. She's the favourite now.
1-7. Two, seven.
The world number 36 still in a healthy lead here.
7-3. Seven, four.
Ooh, indeed. Bit of spice added into the pot. Batra's already called the timeout. Only get one per match. It's all down to her now. Well, Bernie is coming back. Can use this second tiebreak as a mini timeout if she likes. Have a little look over to Balgo in the corner just to see what he may be signalling because Batra is struggling right now. She needs to regain presence mentally. 6-7. Oh, she's still there. Only one away now. This is amazing. 8-6. A massive yard from Aman Balgo. That meant the world. She stopped the momentum. But it feels like it still is with Bernie. Great angle there, though. Batra's done well to press the reset button here because it was getting very edgy indeed. Too close for comfort in a way.
7-9. 8-9.
Again, too close for comfort. I mean, part of Batra's game is meant to be passive, so you can't always use that as a criticism. However, She does look like she's not doing quite enough here, Batra. Shouldn't be napping on Monica Batra. She is not going to bed yet. Still a lot to do, but she's making her mark. Two game points to send this to a fifth. Because she sells herself there. Yes! Oh, the net!
11-9.
Some instant table tennis karma. Will she prove that point here with the serves?
Love one.
You never know when that was. I mean, recently, Bernie, it's been fantastic under pressure. Better than Batra. We'll see what happens. She's not going to miss that one. Just swats it like a fly. On one foot there. So deep. Right on the white line. I think it did hit the edge. There was a raise of the hand as if to apologise there from Bernie. Right in the corner. Batra nearly got it back, but I think it did just throw her off a little bit. That edge ball.
Woo! 1-3.
Jeez Louise, Batra. Took everyone by surprise.
Two,
three. What a rally this is. Wow, Batra's forehand is flying there. Seesaw in final game. The first 3 points went to Bernie, and Batra now has produced a hat trick of her own. At the style bender. Just trying to use the force to get that ball on.
Let's please make sure instead of straight ahead, not backwards. 3-4.
Five, three. Those can be tough times to have to think about adjusting your service. You want to be 100% focused on the task in hand. You can't blame Werner Koller for that. He's just doing his job. Obviously noticed something there that he wanted to just try and warn Bernie about.
6-3. But
my point in case is, it may have affected Bernie a little bit. Everyone has stress. It's about who can manage it better.
4-6.
This is their ninth meeting, and only once before have these two gone to the decider.
Come on.
Batra has a cushion of 2 points here. It was a brilliant serve. Ace length, right in the corner. But I think she admired the serve slightly too long there, Manika, before planting her feet for the forehand. And a tomahawk.
7-4.
Bernie gets the net down the line. To be honest, the net might have actually given Manika more time to get that on. Bernie does the tomahawk now. She says, don't you be doing my serve, Manika. I've patented that shot. Great angle on the third ball forehand. Three in a row from Bernie here. Made that four. Batra sends it long. Dropped the bat and came up the back of a ball that wasn't that backspinny. That is a very interesting time to try that forehand. Strange shot selection there from Bernie. Trying to mix things up, I can understand that, but the execution was not good. But that was.
10-8.
And now, as she puffs out her cheeks and exhales deeply, she's got two match points. It's been another marathon. Who's going to get their nose over the line first? Here he is, Mr. Philemon.
There's
something to say now. She's done it! Bernie Sotch continues to live here on cloud nine.